Okay.
YouTube, hello.
YouTube.
YouTube, hello.
YouTube.
Welcome back. This could be the last mod we do before we return to the wheel. But this, yeah.
Season 2 wheel, or are we still season 1?
Oh, season 1 wheel.
Oh, okay.
I feel like at this point, why even break up the seasons?
I know, just add the newer stuff in.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
I
But anyway,
can't
yeah.
believe you broke my mouse pad.
Okay, I was not me. Why are you
It
blaming that
had
on
to have
me?
been you.
Why are you blaming that on
What?
me?
Because it was fine
Yeah.
when before you came here, and then now it's broken after you came here.
But what would I had to have done to break that?
I don't know. Are you like stretching it or something? And
No? Oh, my mouse pad isn't even like that. I'm not gonna show
I
up to your
know.
house and break your shit.
My other ones aren't like that. Why are you breaking my shit? So rude. Anyways, so what are we doing now?
We're doing what's the last mod? We're doing the last mod before we return to the wheel. But this is a special mod, and we won't say why yet. I muted my microphone by accident, but we won't say why
Is
just yet.
it is a but we won't say why.
Yeah, it is, but we won't say why. All right. So this mod came out somewhat recently. I think it was It's not in the folder. Okay, give me just a second.
It's so super recent that he didn't even download it.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't even have it fucking installed. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Hands in the air like it's good to be alive and in such a small world. I'm all cored up with a book to read.
What? What?
I can't remember back with no handlebars. No handlebars. No handlebars. There we go.
E. Meep, 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 meep.
That's fine. This is a short mod anyway, so
Yeah, you were saying it was like 10 minutes.
yeah, it's probably gonna only be like 10 minutes or so. It's kind of a short one. I gotta get it back up for you.
Yep. Okay,
Okay.
okay.
There we go. Okay. So this mod's called Tiny Dancer. Yes. Warning!
Warning.
The following mod contains copyrighted music. If you're recording slash streaming this mod, it is advised to enable streamer mode. Yeah. We'll mute all that. All right.
Which is so weird because you never listened to the people before. Why are you listening to the people now?
That's a. It's a good
It's a good
question.
question.
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Well, they threw that in Snoon of Darkness too, which is really helpful. So. But yeah. Summer, 201 million 2020 BC. It has only been a month since we all graduated. Fang reconciled with Trish and Reed, and they even started Worm Drama up again. One last little go before the summer ends. Trish backed off a bit, letting Fang take over as band leader. I can turn off webcam. Reed was just happy to bang on his drum kit again. They even started getting asked to play a few shows at some local dives. A certain SnootTube video helped with that. Apparently, someone managed to record Fang's performance at prom and put it up for the whole internet to see. It even got a couple thousand views. Which I guess leads me here. They had me standing off backstage, monitoring the equipment while they played. The crowd's going pretty wild tonight. Figures, Fang wrote the song. Thank God to Jesus for these earplugs. Last thing I need is to make my tinnitus worse. Though I can feel these speakers shake my filling loose.
Whoa, transition.
Yeah, transition. Alright. Even their stage presence has improved tremendously. The more in sync, and even Fang's singing sounds more confident. After Jesus knows I couldn't get up there.
Yeah! Whip them dry. Give it amazing. I'm so good. I play the guitar mentally.
I'm just impressed that you actually fucking made the rest of the shit animated.
Yeah, I like the Rock Band drum kit.
Yeah. Oh, they're already at the end of the set list. I love doing these long moments where they go absolutely ape shit on the instruments. The crowd explodes and cheers. The crowd explodes and cheers as the last of the band's power chords and cymbal crashes echo throughout the gig. With the crowd chanting and raving, the trio takes their leave and run off stage, waving to their adoring audience.
Takes their leave?
Yeah, the trio takes,
Oh god, she left. Transition.
Uh-oh, Fang incoming. Brace for impact. With a guitar in hand, Fang nearly bowls over me, wrapping me in one of her famous winged hugs and spins me around.
And on, we rocked the place.
Yeah, you were amazing up there, Fang.
Man, that's pretty dope. You only caused feedback twice tonight in prison.
Reed shoots his classic finger guns my way.
It was subpar at best.
Thanks, Reed. And Trish. Being on the road with them for the last couple of weeks has certainly taught me a few things. Reed's been showing me how to set up the mixers, the speakers, and all that. Even if Reed's instructions have been plug this thingy into that thingy.
All the thingies. Anon, you're mumbling again.
Ugh.
Man, why are you talking about your thingy?
Fucking mumbling.
Come on, we can hang out in the dressing room while the crowd dies out.
Once most of the crowd had cleared, we
started
getting things placed into Reed's van. We've been using it to travel from venue to venue. I'm sure that's all Reed uses the van for. Okay, Anon, bend with the knees, not with your back, and... If I got anything out of this, I've definitely leveled up my spaghetti arms.
Level up!
Well, that and... Fang. Getting to help Fang live out her dream of rock stardom has been nothing short of absolute bliss. When she gets up on that stage and she pours her heart and soul into her performance, she becomes simply radiant, like a shining star above a new moon night. A smile beaming while the crowd chants her name.
On your right, skinny.
Thought all you Neanderthals did was bang rocks together all day. Figured you'd have some ounce of muscle. Never cease to disappoint. Yes?
Is it two backgrounds that you... or that it stopped at?
I don't know. We'll look into the files once we're done with this.
Okay, because... It's just... Yeah, okay.
And I thought triggers were all too brain dead to pass high school. Guess I had to let one graduate for the sake of equality. Fuck you, spear chucker.
Sorry. Alright, that's the guitars, microphone, mic stands, XLR cables, 6.25mm cables, amp, bass amp, backup amp, mixer board. All that's left is Reed's. My song.
Your song.
Reed, can't that wait for like 10 minutes?
Nope. I already lit it. If you're wasting it, hit it now.
Reed inhales from its homemade bong thermos. Who else but Reed?
Who else but Reed?
Who else but
no
Reed?
No laugh track.
Did Reed just...
Reed!
all things considered, Reed is actually a better driver when he's high.
Good picture.
She must be playing the show over in her head. Her fingers were tapping away at her thigh as if they were still wrapped around her guitar's neck, holding down the strings. Is that humming? It's barely audible over the sputtering of the beat engine, but it's there. It's probably the one thing Feng is hearing now. It's probably the only thing Feng is hearing, though. She's zoned out, lost inside her own studio of her mind. In fact, I don't recognize the song she's humming. Must be thinking up a new one. It's cute seeing her lost in her passion, swept up in the harmonies of music, taken by the beat of imaginary drums, grooving to the funky bass lines. She's beautiful when she's like this. Absolutely divine. Uh-oh. Is I mumbling again? Did I interrupt her?
It's just a weeb.
That's a yes. She shows me her favorite finger again, and I retaliate with a shrug and playful smile.
Wow. Wow.
What? Why? Wow. What? Yes, our love language.
Hey, Reed, can you turn on the radio? Anna and I are gonna head to the back.
Just keep it down, crazy kids.
Roast. Fish rolls her eyes while Reed turns on the radio. It's playing some old Meteor Boomer music. Fang grabs a hold of my arm and signals for me to follow her. Sorry, Zimbabwe and Javelin throwing form. Duty calls. Fang pulls the makeshift divider closed, which was really just a blackout curtain she took from our room. With a firm shove, she pushes me over onto the firm mattress laying on the floor of the van.
No.
The peeking moonlight through the moonroof window illuminates Fang's luscious silver hair, the bangs hanging down over her face as she looks down at me.
Such a dork.
Her beak presses against my forehead, planting a soft kiss dead center.
But you're my dork. Even with all your nerd shows and hats on mic figures.
Her name is Hatsune Miku and she's an international sensation. The sheer audacity to even... Wow, thanks, Fang. That garnered a chuckle. I followed in kind, placing my hands on Fang's love handles, holding her close to me as we embrace one another once more. We lay
she
on the...
She has love handles?
I don't know.
She has love handles?
Doesn't everyone? I thought it was just the name of like an area on your body. Like the side of your hips.
I could be wrong. I assumed love handles were when you had more of a chubby spot there.
Also known as muffin tops. Oh, maybe that, yeah, okay.
Ha 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 ha! You just made Fang fat.
Take that, liberals. Take that, woke agenda. We lay on the mattress holding one another as if for dear life. Fang's finger traces its way around my chest. With half-lidded eyes, we lean in towards each other, bringing our lips together again. Fang's warm to the touch, much more than usual. It's comforting. My own blanket tarot GF. Separating for a brief second, we both catch our breath as we look into each other's eyes. There's amber eyes, like gleaming gemstones. I can get lost in them for hours. Her gentle touch, the softness of her scales as my hand glides across her sides, the bristle of her feathers. We kiss once more, this one far more passionate than the last. I'm madly in love with this girl. Couldn't care less wherever the road takes us. As long as I'm with her, that's all that matters to me. Fang, my pterodactyl rockstar girlfriend, I love you.
And then they fucked.
Hey, who the fuck's that guy? Yeah.
I mean, I already knew.
Yeah, you did. Hey, look at that. I made a thing. I wrote a thing.
Made a thing, wrote a thing, gave Fang
fat. I made Fang fat.
And,
fuck you.
Wrote the script.
I wrote the script. I written
could
the script.
Could not read the script.
I hit quit by accident. Fuck. Okay, so let's play through that again and answer the few questions you actually had.
Oh yeah, my questions.
Yeah.
My first question. Well, I guess it's more of a statement. I still feel like that. Him not knowing that she would be humming is just kind of feels off to me. The rest of it was great.
I should probably have got like a sputtering engine sound effect or something.
I guess maybe a little. Yeah, I think if you would have done that, it would have made more sense. You know, to kind of hear it and then make it seem like he's more questioning whether it's humming, because it just still feels like he's questioning, is she humming? Why would she be humming? And I'm just like, yeah, wouldn't you think you'd know her? No, if she just hums, that it'd just be a thing. Like, you're fucking mumbling. You know? Yeah. So, that's the only thing. Might be a little too mushy, but I think the mushiness is just an insert, so I'm totally fine with that.
I have been told it does get a little mushy.
Yeah, I think it's just a little mushy. But, I mean, it reads, for the most part, like, please just work how I want you to. It's all I want.
It's all you want. Okay, so so this is a different background, of course. This is the club background. This is the warehouse background before they go into the club.
I don't have nothing.
He has nothing.
I see nothing.
Oh, right, because I fucking hit close like a jackass.
Yeah, I see nothing.
Shut up.
Will not. Yeah, so here's the club.
If you notice, if you watched our Goodbye Volcano High Volume 2, that is actually the Warm Drama logo we used for the flag. I thought that'd be a fun little callback. I about said something I really shouldn't have. I about said flag without the L, okay? Like, that would have been really bad. Of course, you can hear in the background, The Future Freaks Me Out by Motion City soundtrack, a song Gerb introduced me to.
I couldn't even hear it.
You'll hear it here real soon. You'll hear it real fucking soon.
I had to turn it up.
Hey, isn't it funny that, like, an arm brings up tinnitus and also having a filling, two things that I have?
Yeah, I told you, insert.
Yeah. Also, there you go. There you can really fucking hear it. So this shot was a pain in the ass. These are two separate photos, of course, to make the layering work. The stage looks like shit. I probably could have done a better job of that. Like, you can see it's going through that person's finger right there.
That, I don't think anybody really cares.
Probably not.
Because mostly they're going to be looking at the good job you did. Arm's a little wonky, but you still did great effort to make Trish's hand move.
Yeah. The
Fang is still not moving her arm.
I'll talk about that in a second.
Okay.
Reed's drum kit, completely intentional. I was like, I should get a good photo of an actual drum kit, and I said, no, what if I make it a Rock Band kit? It'll be funny.
I am very glad you went with the instrumental version.
Well,
the song.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think it would have been weird to have words to it.
Oh, yeah, of course.
In a moment like this.
Especially when it's like, well, Fang will be the one singing it. And it's like, well, I can't have that. there's this weird black line up here. Could not make it go away. It happens because of the background change.
Never didn't even notice
it. Yeah, I know.
Couldn't care too less.
Of course, you can see with Trish, I had to Photoshop her arm off in every fucking thing and do layers. Fang doesn't have a good arm for that at all. So that's why Fang can't play guitar. Because too hard of a Photoshop job.
I mean, I guess you could have just used a different thing and Photoshopped a microphone into her hand.
Probably.
Yay!
And then as we get closer to the ending, it's the final, it's the reprise louder.
Reprise louder
of Future Freaks Me Out.
Oh,
and you can kind of hear that the instrumental isn't perfect because you can still hear the vocal line a little in the back.
Yeah, I don't have it. Well, that's fine. But that's fine.
Yeah, that's fair. Yep.
And she runs away.
Yeah, Fang runs off stage first, so we can
transition.
Yeah. So that's let me get the script up for this actually. That is a background transition that I've never seen anyone use before, and I'm like, well, fuck it, this looks good.
Yeah, I mean, that is very true, and that is why I was like, oh, transition.
Yeah, I was like, why the hell is no one
using
that?
We are star transitioning back into Windows XP in 2003.
That is, what is that? Background music. Yeah, push. That is a push background. Yep.
I mean, it do push.
They slide in one at a time. Nothing really much to say about this scene.
I mean, it is good have them be individual speeds. I do like this, having them move.
You can see somewhere that this is a repeating photo. It's blurred somewhere. You'll see a little bit. I think it's right here. You can see the stamp tool.
Not something to pay attention to.
Oh, no, you can't notice it, but like, yeah, it looks a little good. Very important thing. Yeah, so you got these two moving in the background. Yeah. You notice Reed only goes once.
Yeah.
Yeah, because
we didn't notice that.
Because we will go once back in the back, and to make you go, well, where's Reed? Did Reed break? It's like, no, that's part of the story.
I already assumed it was part of the story where Reed was doing something and Trish grabbed another box.
Yeah.
It's all right there. Yeah. See, she moves, and you just okay.
Yep. It's
maybe Reed will show up afterwards. Maybe he won't. You know. There she goes.
The box and Trish, same thing with Reed.
It's also smart that you made Reed slower than Trish.
Yeah.
Because it makes more sense why she would probably be doing more laps than Reed. Having that visual context clue.
Yeah. They are all separate images, too. So, because the box moves further, because the box has to get off screen fully... It's actually going at a very subtle different speed than Trish.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Lame ass joke. Oh yeah, like if you put this in skip, it breaks the animation. Cause you can see it's different like every time. But like if you just play it normally, you don't notice it. It looks nice and clean, but if you fucking skip it.
It looks like he's struggling to lift it, so yeah. And he leveled up.
Yeah, Final Fantasy fanfare, I had to throw that in there.
Yeah, but now like you got weird transition.
Two separate PNGs.
Two
separate PNGs. There's like a little black line here you can hardly see. That's actually to be the wall. So you're going through like, those overhead doors.
Which would make sense.
Yeah.
If the wall wasn't black at the end. If you may have photoshopped it to match the wall, but, you know, inverted so that it looks like it's going sideways.
Yeah.
Then it would have looked more like it. Right now it looks like they have cut into another scene partway.
Yeah.
But gotcha.
I'm pretty sure people thought that this was a bug too, and I'm like, no, that's just how the PNG is. That's how I made it.
I mean, the best thing about it is it's a learning experience. And for your first one, it's pretty damn good.
God, getting fucking cutting Fang out from the scene to put it back in took me like 2 hours. Oh, you can see I actually had to redraw some sections that got cut out, like right here. I think Fang's arm has a divot. That had to be redrawn. You can see, like, the black line.
Yeah, I see you right there. Right at the bottom.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the window hides behind it. The text box, so it's alright.
But yeah, that was...
Boom.
This is all automatic. To make this fit in the mod jam, Trish does a line, and it would automatically cut over, she'd turn around, and this would all be automatic without you having to touch the mouse.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the point where I said, this doesn't flow well, fuck it, I won't enter this into the mod jam.
Well, yeah.
Only then to have people be like, yeah, you should have entered this. And I was like, oh, cool.
Well, but now you know you can do stuff for the next mod jam. I mean, it's as simple as that.
Still one of my favorite jokes I made. Still one of my favorite lines. Is the equality
it.
Line. You do. You said you actually got a laugh out of it, so I was like, hell yeah.
Yeah.
That was a fun shot. You can see, but this is a bug. You can see Trish is, she flips around, she's on top of Fang, and then immediately behind it. Behind Fang.
Whoa, yeah, show that again.
Yeah. So she turns, above, behind.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. It's pretty fast enough, and I wasn't paying attention the first time, so yeah. It's all good.
Thank you
for going over the entire checklist.
I
made a list of things, and then you said, oh man, maybe I should make the list shorter. Why would I make the list shorter? I looked up all these things.
No. The only thing I had to look up was a 6.25 cable. The rest of these are like off my head because I was like, I need to like make this seem authentic enough. Yeah.
It's a joke.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, I could just said equipment.
But you literally could have been like instruments.
Yeah.
You know.
The van also from when we did GBH season 2.
Yeah.
And of course, can I get this up in the code real quick? Scene 2. This song I had to re-put back in is called Play Music for Curb, Fade In, 1 second, volume 3/4. Underneath is a comment that says, obligatory ska for Curb is completely obligatory.
Yeah. I love this song so much.
Actually, funny enough, if we can hear it here for a second. The rim shot that Reed plays right here is the same rim shot on my soundboard.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it is, yeah. It is the exact same file. Because I was like, I had it, and you know what? It'll be funny to be like, why is none of Reed's drum kit set up? He does the rim shot. And then, yeah. Oh my god, let's talk about these art pieces for a second. I forget their name. Let me get the tweet
you
up.
You had
quick.
Them in the credits.
I do.
Started with a B.
I do, but I wanna. They go by Max, I know that, but I just wanna. Bunny Witch. Bunny Witch drew these for me. I commissioned them, but these came out excellent. They're a little zoomed in than the originals.
But I think they fit well.
Oh, they definitely do.
Yeah.
These are fantastic shots, and I love them to death.
Yeah, because you posted them because you posted the original ones, and so I saw them on Twitter, and I was like, excuse me.
Yeah, because they posted it on Twitter. I was like, yeah, I'll retweet this. I'll support. But yeah, these are great pieces. Literally no fucking notes. They're amazing. And
I love the way they drew Fang.
Oh yeah, it is
especially
very quiet.
That side eye. The side eye is great. Oh yeah, this is very quiet.
Very quiet.
You literally could have had fucking road noise. You could have had fucking engine roar. You could have had little bit of the radio chiming in. You know what I mean? You made this scene so goddamn quiet that it makes no sense. That you're like, is that humming in this dead silence? I hope it fucking is.
I was under a lot of crunch at this point. I think I had like 2 days left of the deadline, and I'm like, I need to fucking get all this done. Oh my god.
That's the reason why when you see something like the Snoot Jam, unless you are gonna make something that you know you can knock out in a week, and you're like, yeah, I'm gonna put a week effort, you know, a week's worth of effort into it. If you want something that comes out great that looks more like a 2 month worth of effort, you make it for the next jam. leave in some open spots in case they change the rules, you know?
Right.
But then you spend that time from when you knowing to the deadline to do with what the rules are. I fucking love this. That fucking side eye little smirk.
Just imagine what our other eye is seeing.
It's seeing directly into her hair.
I sent them that. I sent them, this is what I want. This is all the reference stuff. And I was, the first thing that popped in my head is, what the hell is her other eye seeing? Just straight beak.
She can move her eyes independently. It's looking straight ahead.
There was a thing. Yeah. So someone did say that it is a little too mushy. And
yeah,
I agree. you did too, but it was another. It was the one complaint I've heard of this. Which, I mean, I'll take it. That's it.
It just gets a little too mushy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Whenever I've got to that point writing this in the script, I'd write in a joke. Like, Fang flipping off and on and being like, that's our love language. I was like, that's funny. It's not like a ha-ha, but like...
That's totally fine.
Yeah.
The beginning part is totally fine. I think it's just you're using adjectives and... mainly adjectives. Yeah. Using adjectives and stuff that is just bordering over the top.
Yeah.
You know?
I feel that now that I'm...
She doesn't have to look divine without it being funny.
Yeah.
There's your tiny dancer.
There's your tiny dancer.
Yeah, when I was expecting this to be playing while she was humming and shit. I wasn't expecting it to just start playing afterwards and after dead goddamn silence. You need ambiance, my guy.
Yeah, okay.
And this would have been perfect. A little bit of engine rumble, this sounding like it was playing off the radio, or at least the beginning of it.
Oh, yeah, I did,
telling you.
I did throw it through Adobe Premiere. I did put a little filter over it.
Oh, okay.
It's a little indistinguishable. My guy, and we can't be too quiet, but...
For the next one...
Yes?
Run it through with me before you go to submit it.
Fire enough.
I will be... You know,
yeah,
as critical as I can be, and I will tell you, you need ambiance.
Spear trick.
Hire this person again. Fucking love their art.
Oh yeah,
and then of course Definitely. The bedroom scene.
Yes, the bedroom scene repurposed.
Which is fine. There's nothing wrong with repurposing. But this is where it's getting like... The hats on Mike figures is funny.
I sent you hats on Mike like a month ago. That was the only message I said was like hats on Mike. And you're like, what the fuck? And I'm like...
Yeah, I didn't fucking get it
when
then.
When we get there, it's going to be hilarious.
It didn't make sense. And then now it's like, I get it.
Yeah. Okay, so...
But yeah, this part, totally fine. Totally fine. Then it gets mushy.
Yeah. Okay, so the entirety of this Hats on Mike spiel, Hatsune Mike spiel, is, and I wrote this all off the top of my head. Her name is Hatsune Miku, and she is an international sensation. The sheer audacity to even get her name wrong baffles me greatly. One pixel of Hatsune Miku's astounding beauty is far greater than anything anyone on this mortal coil could ever achieve. Her angelic voice is like ambrosia for the body and the soul. She is a pristine goddess. I will build her temple if she asks me. If she asks me to, I will... Let me get the full thing, because it's meant to fucking break the thing. Yeah. She is a pristine goddess. I would build her temple if she asks me to. I would give her sermons and spread the word of Miku if she demands it. Miku is love, Fang. Miku is life.
Yeah, see, and this is funny when you go over the top in loving Miku.
Yeah.
But the other adjectives of describing Fang is just that borderline.
Now that I'm like...
Same intention... But, like, you chose the big words that you didn't really need to choose. You know?
Yeah.
She don't need to be divine. Not unless you were talking like, you know, that's... Hatsune Miku is divine. That's funny, you know? Your intention of, she's divine. It's like, no, you're getting a little...
Yeah.
White knight.
Yeah, I can.
Beardy territory, my guy. Yeah. So, that's my only thing. Those two things. The non-making sense, because there's no fucking background noise at all. Your tinnitus caught up with you. And then, just a little too mushy.
Yeah.
But other than that, yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking excellent.
Thankfully, the next one will not be romance heavy.
Again, you just learn from it.
Yeah, of course.
And I am also pissed that you all the ones that I was excited to fucking help you with, you fucking put off the table.
Because I need more experience writing.
I know, but you come to me and you're like, what if we do this? I'm like, oh, yeah. And then you're like, nah. Nah.
I think it's really funny that we finished Wani, and I said, we're going to do mods, but I don't think I'll ever make a mod. And then, like, 2 months later, it's like, hey, I made a mod.
Well, hell yeah, you made a mod.
Here you go. Yeah.
Make more mods.
Yeah, also, if you notice in the load, there is literally me testing this shit fucking constantly.
Well, of course. Yeah, of course. You gotta test.
Yeah. Dude, I fucking tested this shit so hard, and, like...
Yeah, well, yeah.
Let me go into... Here we go, yeah. I'll send you this. This is the lobby parking lot, PNG.
Okay. Yeah, see... It needed to be... I think it's probably because it's shifty, but you see the van over there. That's not the big issue.
Yeah.
I think you just needed more of the building off to the side and matching the colors and stuff, like the lighting, because the light out there, that light source is supposed to be hitting it.
Yeah.
If you just did a little bit of that, it would make more sense, because, like, I see exactly what you're thinking, especially with the van in the way. You know, you only get the building and the light, so you're not having that weird angle with it. But, yeah. I think you just needed to work that little side bit. And then you would have been good.
Ugh. Is there
anything... Well, anyways, big clappers.
Is there anything else? Actually, there is. Where is... Here we go. Thanks, Side-Eye. So, I think I told you about this, but now I can show you, like, an actual representation of it. So, this is a custom image I had to make. Because in actual Snoot Game files...
I was gonna say, it looks normal.
Yeah, in Snoot Game files, you have... If I can find them here.
Boom, beam, boom, beam, bum, bum, boom, boom.
Yeah, I think it's, yeah, it's, what, considering and Happy mixed together. Because she, there isn't one of her, like, looking off to the side. Like, being happy. So I had to fucking Photoshop that together. But yeah, there you go. After like
I said, big clappers.
After a month of telling you would do it, there it is, and I am proud of it.
You should be.
And
I'm very glad that it was received well.
Yeah.
I'm very glad the community isn't full of shit like other communities. No, seriously.
Yeah, no, you are right, but yeah.
It made me so happy when you were like, okay, I sent it off and people like it, and I was like, good.
I was sweating bullets for that.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, there's a reason people are afraid to do anything. Because constructive criticism is always good, but some people just hate life so much.
If I can't be happy,
take it out on other people. Yeah.
If I can't be happy, why can anyone else?
You know, first couple chapters of Anon. Being the little fucking bastard he is.
Yep. Well.
Hopefully next week we'll go back to the wheel.
Yeah, wheel will be next week, maybe.
Well, no, it should be. I got an appointment Thursday.
That is true, yeah. So we will be next week.
Yeah, so at least Thursday.
All right, and if you like what we do, why not subscribe, leave a like, leave a comment, all that fun good stuff. You can follow us on the Twitter, or you can join the Discord. Either way, that'll be it for today, and we'll see you all next time.
Bye.